We've got to talk about wonderful meals for the kids.
That's right. Well, we all know that eating together as a family is a good idea, but with busy schedules, it can really be a challenge. But research shows there are just so many benefits. And we have our dietitian, our nutrition coach, Suzanne Farrell, with us here this morning. Tell us how to make things a little bit easier to eat together breakfast, lunch, or dinner.
Yes, that's the key. September is National Family Meals Month, which was established by the FMI Foundation. And it's to encourage families to eat just one more meal per week at home, because the benefits are significant, from better self-esteem, better grades in school, healthier body weights, healthier overall diets, decreased risk for substance abuse. The benefits are pretty significant, so just that one more meal per week at home and you'll reap these benefits.
Okay, so tell us what you have here.
Yeah, so one of my biggest tips is, it's hard, we're busy, there's lots of activities, so just take advantage of what grocery stores now have to offer. You know, I go in the grocery store now, I see shelves of veggies that are already sliced, diced, put together. You can put a stir fry together. So take advantage of what's in the grocery store. Quick and easy proteins, even like Applegate natural and organic deli meat, I personally love. It's by animals that were raised humanely, no antibiotics ever, and no GMO ingredients. And so I posted these recipes on the website. These are mini Italian sliders using these deli meats. My kids absolutely love them. And then these little turkey sushi rolls with avocado in them, so easy to make, and they're really good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, super quick and easy.
And then, of course, if you want to put together a meal, there are these pre-packaged things that can help you out.
Yes, again, at the grocery store. And I forgot to mention, too, with the benefits of family meals, it's breakfast, lunch, or dinner. So, yeah, I love crockpot recipes because you can just do it in the morning and you come home to the aroma of dinner made. So this is a vegetable quinoa soup that my family loves, and I love having it, and freeze it when you don't eat all of it. So basically, you've got some veggie broth.
Okay.
You've got a can of fire-roasted tomatoes, which adds just a little bit of an extra punchy flavor. Frozen mixed veggies. So just a bag of frozen veggies, and then we have a bag of butternut squash. I love that it's diced and ready to go. And then we have a can of rinsed black beans, and then a cup of quinoa, again, just ready to go. And then the spices are about a half a teaspoon each of chili powder, cumin, and salt. You stir it up, you cover it, cook it on medium or low, depending on how long you need it to sit, and voila, your meal is ready, and there it is for you to sample.
So that is really easy.
It's just everything you need.
Yeah.
It's your protein, it's your fiber. You can pair it with the sliders. You can pair it with these other things.
That is delicious.
Yeah, yeah.
And so easy.
That's right. So that's what we're looking for, just quick and convenient. Check out the options in the stores.
Okay, thanks so much, Suzanne.
Yeah.
And then try and get one more meal with the family this week. All right, back to you.
All right, much more to come as we get to the 8 o'clock hour, including the